Good morning. My name is Becca and this is my colleague Claire. And your names are? Thank you. First of all, we'd like to know something about you. Candidate A, where are you from? And what do you do there? Thank you. Candidate B, how long have you been studying English? And what do you most enjoy about studying English? Thank you. Candidate A, do you find it useful that you can speak English when you travel? Candidate B, what type of things did you used to enjoy as a child? Thank you. In this part of the test, I'm going to give each of you three pictures. I'd like you to talk about two of them on your own for about a minute, and also to answer a brief question about your partner's pictures. Candidate A, it's your turn first. Here are your pictures. They show people using different machines or devices. I'd like you to compare two of the pictures and say what problems the people might have with their jobs, and how the machines or devices might help the people to do their jobs better. All right? Thank you. Candidate B, which of these jobs do you think is the hardest? Thank you. Candidate B, it's your turn. Here are your photographs. They show people doing activities in remote places. I'd like you to compare two of the photographs and say why the people might have chosen to do these activities in such remote places and what the dangers might be of doing each of them. All right? Thank you. Candidate A, which of these jobs do you think is the most dangerous? Thank you. Now I'd like you to talk about something together for about 2 minutes. Here are some different approaches to learning and a question for you to discuss. First, you have some time to look at the task. Now, talk together about for what purposes these approaches to learning are suited. All right? Thank you. Now you have about a minute to decide which of these approaches to learning is the least effective. All right? Thank you. Candidate A, why do you think lectures are more common as a form of teaching in universities than in schools? Candidate B, do you agree? Candidate B, what are the advantages and disadvantages of one-to-one teaching from a student's point of view? Candidate A, do you agree? Do you think that project work is an approach that's more suited to younger students or older students? Do you think that exams are the best and fairest means of assessing students? Thank you. That is the end of the test.